Well, howdy there, everyone. This is Star, and I'm playing some Payload Pharaoh as the sniper class using the Bizarre Bargain. And this is a custom map. It's a really good one with a lot of sniper spots. But first of all, I finally made a map pack for my server, so if you play on it and you don't like downloading maps in between rounds because it gets you in so late, or your game has just not been allowing you to download them, that pack is in the description. All you have to do is place the map files in your tf/maps folder and it will work just fine and dandy. Now, onto the actual gameplay. This map is incredible for sniper, because like right here, there is always these big corridor areas where you have a great viewpoint of everyone you want to shoot in the head, and you're really far back so no one can really see you. The downside to that is in TF2, whenever you're on a good sniper map, it ironically becomes very bad for you, because like that guy, you always have spies coming after you. And there's no teammates nearby to defend you throughout this entire map. Every single sniper spot that you get, you just have no teammates to help you out fight spies whatsoever, and it's very easy for them to come up behind you and really ruin your day. So it is good for sniping, but I'm gonna be getting trolled a lot, and I feel like, especially because I'm me, and I'm on my server, and everyone knows who I am, they enjoy backstabbing me and really ruining my day. I know in particular I was playing with Irish Sniper during this gameplay, and he actually said on voice chat, "I know you're going for a gameplay, so I'm going to try and ruin it for you. I'm going to kill you as many times as I possibly can," and that comes up quite a bit later. But it also felt the same for the spies. Naturally, I wasn't talking to them, so I don't really know what their deal was, but sometimes it just feels like I'm fighting against spies who use the cloak and dagger, wait in a corner, and they don't go after anyone until they see me walk by. It really feels like that sometimes. In this gameplay, not so much, but it really did feel like spies were constantly coming for me. Maybe if not for those reasons, but also because I was probably a pretty easy target for the reasons I mentioned before, where I'm in the backfield. There's Sniper getting the first kill on me, coming back as a scout. There are a lot of backroots on this map, which I don't think the attacking team was taking advantage of quite well, but I don't think most people had played this map yet, so can't really expect that from everyone. Once again, you see they turn that corner there, they get the first capture point from the payload, and once again it just brings them into another brilliant sniper area where there's these really, really big wide open areas where you're going to have a lot of opportunities to shoot people. But once again, because it's kind of so wide open and so easy to get around here, this is probably one of the better sniper spots to not get backstabbed, but still it's pretty easy for spies to come up behind that big group of people. And yeah, big part of sniper in this game is managing spies, or managing where you're going to stand so you can feel safe. But one thing we're going to talk about first is the Enforcer, because the Enforcer is the new spy revolver, which does a ton of damage, and I have not won a single 1v1 versus a spy since that's come out as a sniper. There's just like, you have to get really lucky to beat a spy using that. They only have to hit you twice with the revolver and you're down. In order to kill the spy, you have to either shoot them three times with your sniper rifle doing no scopes, get a really sweet headshot, or pull out your knife and get something lucky. But every time I've pulled out my knife and tried to walk on them, they like one-shot me with the revolver because I'm already low on health or whatever. It's just really, really difficult for sniper now, and it's another additional reason why I'm never going to use the Razorback again, because even if they can't backstab you, the revolver kills you in two hits, and it's just, I don't see any point in it anymore, really, because so many people are using the Enforcer now, and because of the patch and because it's a new item, they're kind of reminded to use it. Before, I thought that I felt the same way about the standard revolver, where a spy could just like three hit you with it, but they didn't really try for that as often because they're just like, "Oh, revolver, I'll go for the backstab." But now that Enforcer is new and everyone's got it on their mind, it's really making it kind of worthless. Right there, I felt, while we were playing this, that, you know what, he stabbed me, good job you stabbed me. There's a medic heavy team standing right next to me. Are you really going to go for me instead of the heavy? And then he goes for him afterwards and kind of messes up. I don't know if he was, you know, trolling me, or I don't know. Sometimes I really want to make a replay and just watch what some of the spies do to me, because it does feel like some of them really, really, really hate me. Of course, I'm using the Bizarre Bargain, which increases the amount of heads that you get per headshot, and that increases your charge rate. I've been using the sniper rifle a lot since it came out, but I have not really been taking into consideration the amount of heads that I have anymore. It really doesn't affect me, I don't care. Unless I get to about 3 heads without thinking about it, then I'm like, oh, maybe I should try and keep these. The highest I've gotten so far is 4 heads, and usually directly after I get 3 or 4, I get backstabbed. So it's kind of become a curse where I realize, hey, I have 3 heads, and maybe I should change my spot, or maybe I should, you know, watch out for spies that are going to be coming to get me. This spot, once again, this is actually an amazing sniper spot, because it takes a lot of work for a scout or a spy to get up there. A little bit easier for a scout, but you can kind of get away from them quicker. It takes a lot of work for a spy to get up here, so you feel kind of safe, and right here I have my back into a corner so they wouldn't even be able to stab me. And so it's a really sick spot, and you have this gigantic opening here where they have to walk in a straight line towards you, they have to push the cart through here, so there's a lot of opportunities for shots. There's some even better sniper spots, but a viewpoint talking. And here I die. I completely forgot that that passageway was back there. Had I known, I probably wouldn't have turned my back to the soldier. So, whoops, I learned my lesson. Anyway, as sniper in this game, there's kind of a big metagame of trying to aim to shoot your targets. Of course, that's important. Cool, he burned out. That was funny. And then there is a metagame of worrying if someone's behind you, because the more you worry about a spy coming up behind you, the more your shots are going to be off, because you're going to have to be thinking about 2 different things. You're going to keep wanting to turn around to say, oh shit, is someone behind me? Can I make this shot in time? Oh, it's really kind of a big deal. And of course, at this point, I still have IR Sniper who wants to kill me every single time. So I spy check him. He's not a spy. I've had some bad experiences with spy in this part of the map. This is one of my favorite sniping spots. It has a great view of anyone who comes around that corner, but you've kinda, you know, no one is back here to help you, which is what I keep talking about. So, in just a moment, IR Sniper taunts, tries to kill me, and embarrasses himself. So I'm just sniping, listening. And I hear him say, holy duty, or whatever it is the sniper said, and screw you! I can't believe you tried to do that on me. How are you gonna do me like that, bro? He's just standing there waving, you know, waiting to shoot me in the head afterwards, and he's laughing his ass off in chat right now. So the next couple of shots, I can't even, I couldn't aim. I was laughing with him. It was way too funny at the time that I just got off of that by the skin of my teeth, or some other metaphor that tells you guys that I was really close to embarrassingly dying, and he was gonna make a replay about it and put it up on YouTubes or something, because that would have been pretty bad. So I think for about the next minute, it's safe to say that he's still laughing at me. And my aim, you know, went to shits after that, but you know, still got spies trolling me back there. While I was playing this, it felt like I was dying a lot more than I actually was. Like, I rewatched this and I was like, you know, it wasn't that big of a deal. Every time a spy came after me, it was like 2 or 3 minutes interval in between where I got stabbed. While I was playing, it felt like nonstop I had to worry. And that may have been messing up my shots a little bit. Or you see, every single time after I shoot, I take a minute to look to my left and be like, even there, you know, just who is behind me? What is going on? I don't have any time to shoot. So I think very shortly, I just decide I have to get out of this room because they kind of know where I am. And once a spy, you know, gets used to where you're going, they're going to be very familiar with that and just, you know, keep coming back to kill you. That's, you know, very effective, especially if a sniper's doing well on the other team. Just figure out what spots he's going to and annoy the hell out of him, and he's going to do a lot worse, regardless of if he kills you or not. And here, 1v1 battle with a spy. Can't win it. I try and go for a quick headshot, but get shot seemingly through the wall. 2 health left. I could have killed him had I known that, but it's pretty hard to tell how much a spy's will have health left. And of course, we all know that health does not matter as a spy, and that's the reason that the Big Earner is such a good weapon, because you're never at 2 health, and if you are, you're probably a bad spy, apparently. So I'm just still doing my sniper thing. I'm still really scared. I felt like this was the whole way through, because you could tell I'm still looking around like, who the heck is coming up behind me? This guy, this is a scout now coming to annoy me. I've got so many problems during this gameplay where nobody is leaving me alone. And once again, because all my teammates are up ahead, you know, fighting, and I'm so far behind the actual battle lines that no one can save me. There's nothing I can do. So I felt like I was doing terrible, but, you know, come the round end, I actually am top scoring, which blew my mind because it didn't feel like that. So I think one thing I should have done better in this gameplay overall was not worry about it so much. Like, if I was going to get backstabbed, that's only going to, you know, take me out of the battle for, you know, maybe 12 to 18, 16 seconds. It kind of varies. So about 10 seconds off the battlefield, just for the peace of mind to say, I don't care if I get backstabbed. I'm just going to aim, you know, do my best. I think I would have, you know, came out a lot ahead if I had done that and just not worried about it nearly as much. But I kind of had to worry about it during this gameplay because I did not want to get taunt killed by Sniper, and I knew he was coming back for me. Because at this point, I still think he was laughing. I know that happened quite a while ago, but he's still, you know, going on and on in chat about how awesome that would have been, and he's coming for me. He's going to ruin my gameplay and make me look like a fool. Well, that's cool. I think I kill him in a second. That scout is not helping, trying to freak me out, shooting me. So, yeah, there he is. I miss. I can't believe I missed that shot. It looked like a hit to me, but he, like, goes AFK around the corner. So, you know, who's the cool kid now? I killed you. That's what's up. And in a moment again, because this guy freaked me out too. I heard his footsteps and he swings at me, so I'm getting freaked out by every possible thing. And in a moment, a spy decloaks next to me, and he kills me. And I probably shouldn't have worried about it, because this whole time I'm freaking out. And there he goes. And you know the spy is after specifically me when he taunts after he kills you, close range with a revolver. And he's just like, yeah, I'm a badass, I killed Star. I don't know what's going through your head. I'm sure you're probably going to watch this video. So I want to know, were you trolling me? Or was it just coincidences through some of these skills? Because there have definitely been gameplays where people, you know, wait specifically for me. Anyway, round's over. Hope you enjoyed this gameplay. Top scoring as a sniper, showing off the new bizarre bargain. Use the knife, but not so much. We'll talk about that more later. Catch you guys later.